children, today I am going to take your English as well as geography class. Let me first take your English class. Take out your English literature book, Roots, Chapter 7, A Handful of Clay. Today I am going to give you the answers of reference to context. Number 5, My time will come, it said. Number A, who speaks these words? To whom are they said? Answer, these words are spoken by the clay to itself. Number B, what caused these words to be said? What does this tell about the speaker? Answer, the clay saw the river rejoicing in the unison of all its water. So it said this verse. This tells us that the speaker wants to spread his glory, beauty and honor in the upcoming session. Number C, did the speaker's time come? Explain how. Answer, yes, the speaker's time came when the clay was turned into a pot and the flowering plant was planted in it that added beauty to the nature and it was a great treasure. Number 6, the clay rebelled at this new disgrace. Number 8, why did the clay think it was facing a new disgrace? Answer, the clay thought so because when it was turned into a pot, it had an ugly look and was filled with dirt and rubbish. Number 7, was it right in thinking so? What was actually happening to the clay? Answer, no, it was not at all right in thinking so. Actually, the pot was filled with dirt and rubbish to make the soil fertile for the growth of a healthy plant. Number C, what conclusion did the clay come to upon facing the situation? Answer, on facing the situation, the clay came to the conclusion that it was a total failure. Number 7, do you not know? Number 8, who is the speaker? Where is this line spoken? Answer, the other vessel is the speaker. This line is spoken at the church. Number B, what does the listener not know? Answer, the listener doesn't know why people look at them. Number C, what is the listener's response to hearing the speaker's full explanation? Answer, after hearing the speaker's full explanation, the speaker was content and silently thanks its maker because though an earthen vessel, but it held so great a treasure. Number 9, after immense suffering and patient waiting, when the clay saw itself in the pool, it was elated or frustrated. Why? Answer, after immense suffering and patient waiting, when the clay saw itself in the pool, it was frustrated, as when the final result came out, it was found that it was just a common flower pot, straight, stiff, red and ugly. Number 10, is this just the story of a handful of clay? Is it an analog of something else? What can it be? Explain, why do you think so? Answer, it is just not the story of a handful of clay. It is an analogy of something else that gives clarification about the soft clay whose credit goes to its maker. I think so because the maker of the pot uses the soft clay and passes through different stages to make an earthen vessel that holds a great treasure. And with this, I am ending my English class. Now, let me take your geography class. Take out your geography book. Chapter 5, Industries. Today, I am going to give you the question answers of this chapter. Number 1, what is the importance of industries? Answer, industries are needed for the fulfillment of basic needs. The economic strength of a country is closely linked to the industrial development. Industrial advanced nations are the strongest and the most powerful nations of the world. Industries helps in bringing innovative products to the market and create employment opportunities. It provides a reliable source of income for many households and facilitates the use of natural resources for their full potential. Number 2. Differentiate between the cottage industries, small-scale industries and large-scale industries. Answer, cottage industries are mainly home-based industries where goods are produced using simple tools rather than complex machinery, whereas small-scale industries are those that uses a limited amount of capital, while large-scale industries are characterized by huge capital investment, heavy mechanizations and modern technology. Number 3. What are the factors that influence the location of industries? Discuss. Answer, factors influencing the location of industries are number 1, proximity or nearness of raw material. Industries are generally located near sources of raw materials and they reduce the cost and difficulties of transportation, availability of labor. Industries are generally located near the well-polluted areas so that they can hire a bigger workforce at a lower cost. Proximity to markets. Industries are generally located near markets to save transportation cost and storage cost. Efficient systems of transportation. Well-developed and efficient systems of transportation are needed for the movement of raw materials and finished goods. Availability of power and water. A cheap and steady source of power is essential for industries. Industries also use hydroelectric power, wind energy and oil. Government incentives and policies influence the location of industries. Availability of capital. Industries with large inputs are generally located near towns and cities that have banks and other financial institutions to provide loans. Number 4. Write a brief note on the cotton textile industries. Answer. Cotton textile industries has the most demand among textile worldwide. In India, the production of trade of cotton textiles had taken place since ancient times. Production was initially done by hand and then with simple tools and machines. Today, the textile industries is one of the biggest generators of the employment in India. Question 5. What are the main uses of sugar? Name 3 of the leading producers of sugar in the world. Answer. Sugar is mainly used as a sweetener and is a key ingredient in the food processing industry. It is also used in the manufacture of medicines. Brazil, India and China are the leading producers of sugar in the world. Number 6. What are the main causes of industrial pollution? What are its effects? Answer. The main cause of industrial pollution are number 1. Dumping of industrial waste into landfills and water bodies. Number 2. The unplanned and uncontrolled expansion of industries. Number 3. Deforestation and overexploitation. Number 4. The use of outdated technology. Number 5. Lack of strict punishable laws. Its effects are number 1. Causes respiratory diseases. Pollutes land. Oil spills causes water pollution and excessive emission of greenhouse gases by industries causes global warming. And with this, I am ending my today's class. Goodbye.